Alright, so now I got this problem. Now again, let's pretend it's something that I know how to do. Let's pretend it's this one. Alright. So hopefully you'll say, alright. That's going to be x minus and 3 and 4. 3 and 4. Yep, that works. So x minus 4 is 0, x minus 3 is 0. Add 4 to both sides, so x is 4. Add 3 to both sides, so x is 3. We've got x is equal to 3 and 4. Unfortunately, that's not our problem. But there is a similar problem hiding in here. So our problem is, you may not think of it this way, but our problem, we have something squared, minus 7 times something, plus 12. This x, what you want to think about, is that this x is actually equal to the square root of x quantity squared. Does that make sense? Square root of x squared? So really what you have is the square root of x squared plus, minus 7 times the square root of x plus 12 equals 0. So really what we have is we have something squared minus 7 times that same something plus 12. So we'd like to do a substitution. We're going to say let u equal to the square root of x. You're always going to let u equal to this middle term. Whatever that little middle term is that's multiplied by the constant, that's what you're going to let u be equal to. Okay? So if we do that, so instead of the square root of x, I'm going to write u. So here instead of square root of x, I'm going to write u. So I now have u squared minus 7u plus 12 equals 0, which I can solve. U minus 4, u plus 3, do-do-do-do-do, u minus 4 is 0, u, except I can't do this, there we go, u minus 3 is 0. So u equals 4, or u equals 3. Now I'm going to back substitute. And I'm going to say square root of x instead of u is equal to 4. And the square root of x instead of u is equal to 3. So now I can get rid of the square roots by squaring both sides. So I've got square root of x squared is x. 4 squared is 16, and then x is equal to 9. So those are actually my solutions for that problem. Okay? Alright. Now let's look at that last example. Let's look at this last example for quadratic substitution. I'm going to pull this one. Pull it down here. So again, what we really wish is that we wish we had a problem that looked like this. We wish we had x squared minus 4x minus 12 equals 0. Because if we did, we could rewrite that as x minus 6, x plus 2 equals 0. So x minus 6 is 0, or x plus 2 is 0. So x equals 6. Or x equals negative 2. Not too bad. So we like that. Unfortunately, again, that's not the problem that we have. But what we do have is something similar. Probably a bit of a stretch, but you may remember that x to the 1 half is the same thing as the x to the 4th squared. Now remember that, because if you have x to the a all to the b, that's the same thing as x to the ab. So if we have x to the 1/4 square, that's the same thing as x to the 1/4 times 2. So it's x to the 8 over, except I can't multiply it, x to the 2 over 4, which is x to the 1/2. So we've got that, x to the 1/2. Okay, so that's what we have up here. So what we really have now is x to the 1/4 squared minus 4 x to the 1/4 minus 12 is 0. So what we want to do is we want to substitute. We want to let u equal to that middle term, x to the 1/4. So if u is x to the 1/4, then that means everywhere I put an x to the 1/4, everywhere I have an x to the 1/4, I'm going to put a u squared minus 4. Instead of x to the 1/4, I'm going to write u. And then minus 12 is 0. Now I've got something I can factor. Like that. I've got my u's. And this is going to be the same way I factored it last time. Minus 6 plus 2. So that means u minus 6 is 0, or u plus 2 is 0. So u equals 6, or u equals minus 2. And now I will back substitute. Alright, so everywhere I see a u, now I'm going to put an x to the 1/4. And to get to root of the 1/4, I need to raise each thing to the 4th power, right? X to the 1/4 all to the 4th is x to the 1/4 times 4. It's x to the 4 over 4, which is x to the 1. So that's how I get rid of the 4th root, is I take everything to the 4th. So that gives me x equals 6 to the 4th, which is something like, oh, I don't know, 36 squared, which is something like 1296, which was not really intentional to make the number that ugly. Raise both sides to the 4th power. So x equals negative 2 to the 4th. So x equals 16, positive 16. So x is equal to 16. Or 1296. And that is the joy of quadratic substitution.